So I've just loaded up the world and, oh, apart from that lag spike, I've noticed that we are about to hit a milestone. So let's get this on camera. 2,600 residents we need to hit. Currently we've got 2,520, as indicated there. So what we're going to do is just go speed up the game and hit that milestone. We've got a building burning down there, which should be seen to. But yeah, this traffic problem still is very bad. So we'll go have to build that roundabout at the beginning of this episode, like I said, that we're going to. And there we go, that fire did get put out. And 2,600 we need. Okay. So if we keep expanding. And also, I've noticed this. Buildings can now upgrade, which is great, because that means that we get a lot more like residents able to be moved in and things. And I'm actually going to check on education. Education's fine. Maybe another high school in the future, but for now, it's all good. There we go, we've hit it. So we're now a boom town, we can unlock another area. We've got transport and buses, or industry specialisation. We now got access to the highway, which is one thing that we're going to be using quite a lot. I'm going to place down a cemetery for the dead people. I know that wasn't said in the best way possible. I'm going to place down the cemetery because people are going to start dying around the city, and we'll get some hearses on that to take care of that issue. So if we place down a cemetery next to a landfill, is not the best place at all. We're going to have it down here. It's fine to replace some houses. Citizens love it. And actually, I want to move that further up there so we can have it as far down as possible. Because I've been watching Assuma Void, and it's better to take up more of these little gaps than it is for anything else at all. So yeah, we're going to be building that roundabout straight off at the beginning of today, and we're going to do it on camera, actually, for the basics. We're going to do the basics on camera. So what we're going to do is we'll pause the game, and I'm just going to detach absolutely everything. Remove all roads, that is. We're going to detach the power grid for now. And move that over to there. So, right. The best way to do this is to grab a road and run it all the way across. Now I'm going to join it up to here. Oh, maybe I can't. Right, so it's going to be... That seems to be wonky, but I don't know why. Now, we're going to find the middle, which is about there. Yep, that's the middle, spot on. We're going to go to there on either side. So, that's the middle area. And now, what we're going to do for the thing for the roundabout is we're going to have a one-way road, and we're going to bring this into the curved mode, and we're going to go out to there and up to here. Now we could do a demolition this bit so that that doesn't conflict, and then while we're at it, we'll take out this and re-implant that other one so it's nice and straight, because that wasn't straight, was it, the first one that we made? And this should now go straight. And that's going curved, and I don't want it to, so we'll use a straight road tool and just fit that nicely into there. Now, curved road tool again. We're going to get this, we're going to bring it straight out to this little area. Oh, wrong place. Make sure it lines up exactly with the grid, and then I'm going to bring it down over to there. From here, we're going to go out again, and we're going to have to remove this road. We're going to have to remove quite a bit around here, but it's a good job that we're doing this while the game's paused, because otherwise, this will be absolute mayhem. And we actually want to go past that by one, I believe. Because otherwise we don't... Yes. Otherwise we don't get the curve that we are after. Now, I'm going to want to bring this along again, and to that level, and then in. Like that. Down again. That level and in, but we're going to bring it to there to make a full circle. Not the best way of doing things, I know. We've done that in the poor way, so that half is right. This one we did incorrect, only a tiny bit incorrect. That's going to need to go even a bit further over there, and then here. No, one less. Like that. So there we go. There is the road right there. Currently, the video that I published today on Cities Skylines has currently got 3 likes, which is quite good. I published it, well, it's now, what is it, it's 9:15, and it was published at around about 6:30. So I'd say it's doing pretty good for the amount of time that it's been up and running. Now, these are 3 lanes, so we'll go drag and put that one to there, hopefully. But I do want to upgrade this to a highway, so for now, we'll add these in. But, yeah, highway is going to be added in pretty soon. I want to just change them to that way so that they match up a little bit differently, you know. It would help to use the straight road tool, yep. Oh, gosh. Why does it want a curve so much? You know what? I'm going to use the highway because less curves. And we'll go upgrade to highway anyway. So that can now be removed. And now we'll replace with fabulous highway road. There we go. So that looks clean enough for me. Now we've got this road connecting up, which is fine. And now we'll just go ahead and connect this road down here. It's going to come off at a dodgy angle, isn't it? Can I not get that straight? Try. That's probably, no, that's as straight as I can get it. Okay, that is fine. So we're going to lose all this industrial area down here, which I'm fine with. And we're also going to demolish these water pipes, because we don't need those. I know it's not necessary, because they're only water pipes. And now we'll add in some extra water pipes. Well, we should have left those in, so I'll put them back in. Don't know why I did that. Let's move that up. There, so it's still going as if there's a road there, if that makes sense. And now all that's left to do is the electric. And what else we're going to do is just quickly replace these roads with highway. We'll eventually unlock the barrier highways, which are much better. So yeah, we're already on highway. Some thing that I didn't know, we are already on highway. That's a highway slip road and this is a highway. So yep, we've got highway all the way up here. And now then. Yep, that's everything. So there's our roundabout. Nicely made. And water's fine. We'll just have to sort out the electric situation. So what we're going to do for electric, we're going to run it over and into the centre of the roundabout. Back out. And into there, like that. So that is now connected using electricity, and now we'll go see some cars floating. Oh, well, I sped it up too fast, but usually you see cars floating after you've done some maintenance work. And now let's have a look. Traffic, that is amazing. We have just solved a problem in itself, and we're actually going to need an extra road going down here, because if you remember, we've just demolished one, so we're going to need an extra one, which I'll just go ahead and add in right now. Industry and there, and now we'll go add some water. We're gonna need water pipes down every road eventually when we upgrade these roads to the next type and things, get the one ways going. But things are seeming to expand at a nice rate. Have we got any dead people yet? Nope. No dead people. I shouldn't really say it like that. We've got no one deceased just yet, so that's fine. Garbage is doing great. We've got some trucks in use taking stuff out. And high school is fine as well for now. What electric is brilliant as well. So everything is seeming good around the city. I think I'm just going to expand at a gradual rate. We are going to need some more commercial. And I'm thinking about buying this tile down here so that we can add some shops just short of there. But do we really need to buy a full tile to do that, or can we add in something like around here or something maybe? I'm not sure. I'm not sure the best way to do that or how to go about doing so. But anyway, I'm going to keep an eye on the city, see how things go, and expand as needed. And I'll come back and explain to you guys what I've done. So, currently in terms of expansion, we have got a new... I've extended this road down, so we've got a new place for all the rubbish and things, and that worries me. Is that just a spike, or is there actually water issues? Right, that may have just been with me moving the electric down. Yep, I think it is. I think it's the fact that the electric now has to travel a little bit and it's just restoring it all. So I've added this road in extended so that we can add some more residential, because if you look at the demand, we have got a lot of demand for the residential areas. So I'm going to start off by extending down these areas so we can have some residential down here. But I'm not going to go too close to the landfill yet, which is why I'm moving it. So we can add some more residential in. So we'll go up to there on each, and for that reason we'll stay about there. Put in the water pipes all the way down. I'm not going to do any water pipes that we don't need just yet, and there's an IM, but just ignore that. I really do need to get used to turning off those sounds while I'm doing something, but anyway. So now we can zone out this as residential. I had industrial selected. Oh, not that one. This one and this one. So there we go. That's that. And yeah, it's looking good. Things are going down well. And I think I'm actually going to add a row in here as well, because it should be okay. I don't expect anything major to go off or anything, so we should be fine with doing that. And that should take care of that issue. Doesn't take care of commercial, but hopefully we can have a nice commercial area around here or something. I'm not sure just yet, but we have all got this whole space to use as well. I'm not sure what I'm going to use this for. There is a lot of planning that needs to go into all this, and also the traffic issue. It resolved itself with the roundabout, but we're going to have to make these roads one way sometime soon. I've done that in the other world that I have. And what we're going to have to do is make these one way going down and this one way going across, so they come in through the roundabout down there, and then they exit out onto a highway, which I'm going to add in down here. So it's essentially going to mean that they just aren't waiting here at these intersections, because if you look, where is it, around here, we've got traffic lights there. If I turn off this view, we'll be able to see it a lot better. We've got traffic lights, and cars are waiting here for those to shift, and they can't move until these are done. So that is the issue. That's why we need to add in everything else. But I'm going to speed up the game just a few ticks to get this rubbish moved out of here and down to this landfill. It's 7% full, and the truck's in use. Yep, 15 out of 15 to move it down, and 14 out of 15 to move it down to there, which, yeah, we need that. So that's all good. And has we got any deceased yet? Yes, we've got one deceased. Okay, I said that in sort of a celebration, but I'll just check in, make sure that everything is running smooth, because I expected us to have one person to have deceased by now. But healthcare is really good. There's no reason why anyone should be, because heal capacity is at 100, and the average health is at 74%, 73%. It seems to be going up and down around there. So, yeah, things are looking good. I'm going to keep working on this, move over the rubbish, and I'll catch you in a moment. So it finished emptying, and I've gone ahead and bulldozed that down, so it finished emptying, and I'm just thinking about raising the taxes. I thought I'd do this on camera. I'm going to put these up to 11%, because that seems to work good when I've done it in my other world, and I've had no issues so far at all. And I've just realised, oh, we're still on a loan. Okay, I thought that we didn't have a loan and we just had this money just built up there, but yeah, that is not the case. And eventually we can take out 200 grand. That is quite decent. So yeah, we're doing good so far. I'm going to add in some more roads here. We'll actually do that on camera real quick. And fill these in. We'll go downgrade this one to that type, because we don't need the two lanes until, well, there really. Because we're fine for quite a while. We're not going to need any massive two lanes. And now when it comes to here, we're going to want to pause the game, because we need to move these lines. We need to move the power lines, so let's detach those, because that's going to cut off the whole electricity for the whole town if I left the game unpaused. So instead we're going to bring these all the way over, and then the much issue of getting power. Is that going to work? That's in the boundary, isn't it? Yeah. That sure does work. So, power's cut out for now. Oh! The power station is on fire. That's not good. Let's add in a fire station over here to make sure that none of that's going to happen. Actually, we'll add it in. Well, we'll add it in down here. So we've got one in the industrial, none in the residential, so that one is going to be fine. Have we got a power issue? Let's just keep this checked. Yes. Seems to be the answer. So that isn't powering that. It should be. Oh, consumption's more than production because it's on fire. I get it. Right. Come on. Put it out because we've got masses of issues. Arrgh. Right, I'm going to have to turn up the budget. Until then, because this is absolutely crazy. So we're now producing a ton more electric. It's not going to be enough. Ah, is it burnt down? I don't know. Is it being put out? Has it been put out? I'm not sure. Yes, it's now fine. It's working. So we can turn down the budget again. And that should be fine. I'm not definite. That was really bad having a fire like that. Alright, so we're going to have to put the budget up anyway. Even with those two. So we're going to raise it to like 120%. So like that. Yes, I understand. Oh, it doesn't have enough water. Okay. So we'll draw in the water pipes going down here. We're just basically need to extend whatever we're going to extend. And where was I? Yes, I was zoning housing. Well, going to. So there. And let's bring this one up. Okay, so we're not going to be able to bring that one up. Let's go there. Zone that. And then we'll zone right away across. I've missed that whole line. At the bottom. There we go. So we've got a bus depot. Yep, I understand that. We'll get into buses later on down the line. For now, things are fine, I guess. Although, landfill. What's the situation with that? Right, so it's sending out its trucks and it's already in use already, so let's place down another landfill. And I'm just going to keep monitoring things, making sure that things are okay. So, something needs to be done right now to fix this issue. We've got garbage trucks coming in to collect garbage. I've actually opened up loads of these now, I realise. No, actually it's not this fault, it's the actual traffic over there that's not picking up the garbage because of this. So, what we're going to do is we're going to have to remove every single road, and yes, I've got enough money to do this. That was where the error was last time. So let's demolish every little bit of the road like this. And all I'm going to do is I'm just going to replace it to one way, which actually I'll do in off camera right now, so I'll catch you in a moment. Okay, so what I have just made theoretically should work. I'm just going to speed up the game so we can get power into the area and things, because well, we should be doing that, but for some reason that's not connected, so we're going to just give it a tick. Yep, it's connected anyway. So we're going to remove this one because we don't need this anymore. It's somehow connected. And there we go, we've got industry popping back up. And now if we take a look at the situation, what we've got these going down in one way. I know I can't really represent that without showing you, but it's going to help the traffic, put it that way. If we go to the traffic view now, we've only got a bit of traffic around here. But that only seems to be when these are in use. So for now, I'm going to shut off these landfill sites because these aren't needed. I'm going to keep three open because this one's nearly full, and these will help with the load anyway. Actually, I'll shut that one off so it can just run on too. If I notice any issues, I can always turn one back on. So, yeah, I'm going to keep an eye on the city, and I'm going to do some slow expansion, making sure things are running fine. I've extended this highway down to here, and yeah, I'm just going to keep going nice and slow, making sure that everything runs smooth. So, I was an idiot in the last bit. I don't know if you noticed, but I did the motorway going all the way, not the motorway, the highway. I did it going up this side, going upwards this way, and back down this way, which was a big boo-boo when I was being the UK typical person. Of course, we've got a American road layout, so the highway is on the right. Now, it's not necessary for a highway to be working that way, but, well, because it's one way, but it's more needed. And this just makes me more happy because we've got it coming in on the right here and leaving on the right there, which is much more logical rather than going round here and then turning in. And yeah, I've added some more things in over here. If we have a look, we've got this little road coming down, and I've added some more residential, commercial zones into that area. So this is now building up commercial. I just had to zone that last bit. And we may be able to add some more houses in this area. I'm not sure what we'll do. Maybe just add a big, huge commercial block or something. That's what I've done in my other world with a space like this. But yeah, I bought that tile so we could do that. And we are going to have a fancy island over here eventually. It's not going to be too special, I know. I assume we've already made one called Avalon. It's not going to be copying that. It's just going to be a nice little island that I make. And you guys will name it. Not Avalon, because that's his. So yeah. We do need to build some residential districts. So what I'm going to do, I think. Oh, what should I? Right, what's wrong with the garbage? We ain't got it powering up, or do we? No, it doesn't seem to be. Right, so we've got that. We've demolished that one. And over here, 15 out of 15. Right, so we're going to open up this one. So this landfill can now be turned on. And that should alleviate issue. Alleviate the issue. And that should be fine. If we take a look at traffic management. It's getting red around this area now. Now what I think I want to do is upgrade this to a highway, this roundabout, so traffic can zip around it a lot faster, and it's not going to come to anything extra. We've also got to lose some lanes from 6 lanes. Yeah, 6 lanes. Is that 6 lane? Yeah, 6 lanes one way, down to 3 lanes, but they can zip across this a lot more faster. A lot faster, not a lot more faster. But yeah, there's that. So that should have alleviated some traffic because there's a better speed limit on this. Yep, as you can see, that is quite a bit better, it seems. And we may have to make all this one way as well because you can see issues arising around here. Now is the best time to spot any issues like that. We can't control any of this really over here. And we're now starting to run low on the water situation. Yeah, right, and electric in general. Is there any extra electric that we can do? We haven't unlocked oil power plant yet, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn up the budget, actually. Oh, it's already at maximum. That's kind of bad. I've had to turn up the budget for the policing as crime rate is on the rise. I'm going to slow the game down because we've got quite a few issues to just look at. If we look at crime rate there now, it's down to 3%. That was all the way up at like 12 and 13. And look at this pollution. That is absolutely disgusting. Ugh. I hate that. Let's go all the way over to the island, what we want to make beautiful in the end. So we will have to do something about that soon. Now, oh, that's right. I didn't extend this down. So that's all the issue should be with water. Now, the other issue, yeah, is electric. We're not producing what we should be really. So I'm going to place down another one of these. We're going to be removing these for the oil ones later down the line anyway. And that no longer goes anywhere. So we're going to have to bring that into there, that pylon, and now we should get power again in a moment. Now we're going to be adding some mods in further down the line. I'm not sure when about, so we're going to be doing this, but there will be some mods added in, different useful utensil mods that I've seen, mostly through watching the Sumo Void. But yeah, we'll be adding in some mods, and we got 7 likes currently today on the last video. I'm not sure if it's any higher than that right now. I will give it a check. I'll load it up on my second monitor while we're playing so that I can have a look. If I can. Otherwise, YouTube, it's not very good loading stuff up in midway through a video. My videos, there we go. So I'll just leave that to load. And yeah, so we seem to have a water issue. Whether this is pollution related or just intake related, actually we need to. That's the water output, but I'm not going to do anything over there yet. And what we're going to do is add this in, because eventually we'll go get the advanced sewage water pipes that should get a lot more sewage out. No, it filters the sewage first. Is that connected up? Let's have a look. Yes, it is. Is the answer. And they're both draining, so that's going to mean a lot more pollution and some low frames. There, the video is loaded up. 9 likes. 9 likes and 1 dislike. That is absolutely amazing. That means that we are now daily. This is being recorded on a Wednesday to come out on Thursday. So I'm feeling good about this. I started some of it yesterday, which is why I didn't have the exact like figures. But now I do, and that is an amazing likes thing right there. And I'm really happy with that. Now, things are going good. I need to keep my eye on things. I am going to add in another residential area soon. And I've got an idea where I want to add that in. And how I want it to look. It is just getting the balance and things at this moment. Like, there's more commercial and he's doing. I think I'm just going to zone all this into commercial. Which I'll do. Actually, I'll do that now and I'll show you what it looks like when I'm done. In a moment. So, this is the situation that we have now. I've added in all this. And they are the 2-lane types on either side. For the traffic management, we can upgrade those into 1-way. In future, have this just a ring road with 1-ways. But there's one thing that I want to add here, and that is a district. So I'll go ahead and do this now. And the game has been a slight bit laggy there. So let's have a look. If we outline in the smaller one. Actually, these stick to roads, I've noticed. Let's remove that, because that's not needed. If we go down this road, they stick to roads, or at least I thought they did. Well, they do. So, we're just going to go down like this, and this is going to be the commercial hub, which is what I named my district in my test world for this. I want you guys to rename it, and leave in the comments what you want its name to be, because commercial hub, yep, it is a bit boring. And we're just going to extend this all the way down here, give it some good leeway around there. There wasn't much point in adding it to the roads, was there? If we're just going to do this, but anyway, scale it up and across. And we're not going to get any of the commercial, this is just going to be it, the commercial hub right here. Actually, yeah, we will. We'll go all the way up to here, just this little bit right there, get that bit all in. And then all the way down here. And that should be pitch perfect, if that's a thing. But yeah, you get what I mean, that should be perfect when I've done that. So let's bring this nicely across, and there we go. District is being created, and now we've just got to fill in the white gaps with this paint tool. So, oh actually they've not merged. They are coming up as separate things. So what we need to do is make this into all one. So that's very strange. We've got Sterling Heights and another one. Strange stuff. Anyway, that should now work. Oh, apart from that bit. Orchard Heights. This is annoying. There we go. Robin Square. That's a quite nice name, actually. But we'll go rename it. We'll go call it Commercial Hub. And I want you guys to put in a name in the comments section. I will look through them and see which ones we're going to have. Actually, Commercial Square sounds better. Take it on from the square of the other one. Cause I know it's not a complete square or anything. But it sounds better than anything else that we could have. So Commercial Square it is. No specialisation. We're not going to put any policies on that at the moment. Now, that's done. And all that's left to do now is the residential area issue that we'll go after adding. The extra residential area, so that's all that needs to be done. Actually, I may expand some residential down here. I'm not sure. We'll have to see how commercial goes, because commercial, no demand anymore because we've opened up all of this. If we look at how I've done the water, perfect. So, yeah, we'll have to see how it goes. I'm happy with that there. And, yeah, so I'm just going to expand this down, I think. Maybe add a little roundabout down here and have some residential up here. That's what I've done in a previous world, and it seems to work the best. And I believe I've told you about the sewage and everything. Yep, everything seems to be running fine. And we could actually turn down the budget on the electric now, because we don't need that much. Possibly as low as 100%. Anyway, I'll work things out and I'll see what time I'm on for the episode as well, because I might have to do quite a bit of off-camera work if we're near the end, because I'm trying to get a lot done in this episode, but I don't have massive amounts of time until I'm wanting to render this thing up, so I'll catch you in a moment. Okay, so we're about to hit a population milestone right here, 4,800 to hit, and we've currently got 4,750, and that is going up by the minute. So we're going to hit that and get all of these, the new road types, and then we can get some of the high density stuff, I believe. No, maybe not. I don't know. Can we get high density? No, not yet, but we get oil industry specialization, so that means that we can get the oil power plant and a hospital. So that's going to be good. I've added in this area, which I'll talk about when we hit that goal. So there we go. Goal has been hit. And look at this money. This is all purely ours now. I've paid back all the loans. So we've now got £150,000 of our money, or euros, whatever it is. And so what we're going to do is we're going to replace two of these with a oil one, because I believe that's how it works. Each one of these delivers how much electric? 40, and this delivers 120, so we can actually get rid of them all and just replace it with one oil one, and that would be no problem. Right, so there's a few changes that I need to talk about. First, we'll just add in the electrical wires going down to here, so that's going to mean that we get a lot more electric. Now, the changes. This roundabout, quite good. Takes the breeze off the traffic, I think. No one uses this end road because there's nothing there, it's not needed. It's just a little extension so that I know where to come out in the future. And this is all... No, it's not highway, actually. It should be highway. And now we've got access to the highway with grid, so I'm going to use that. So I've upgraded all of the highways to the ones with these highway barriers, and that's going to stop bad sound. And this looks strange. That was from where I changed the road, because we couldn't have it straight anymore with those barriers. And now things seem to be moving okay. Look at traffic. Yeah, that can be a bad spot, but there, it's resolved itself. It was just a minor issue, it seems. So that's resolved. And if we look at noise pollution, which is right here, these barriers are going to keep it out. So there's noise pollution here, and then the barriers, these sound barriers stop that, so there's no noise pollution. And we can see there, that looks like a one that I haven't upgraded. Let's check. Yep, there we go. We could tell straight away by the pollution levels. So yep, that is that, and that is really good. That's upgraded as well. I don't know why that's a bit more noisy. But anyway, I've added in this residential area over here and done the waters pipes like that. This is eventually going to be the high density one. That's why I've done this on the double side road, so that we can eventually change this to high density and get high rise population like flats and things. So yeah, everything is going good around the city. I'm going to have to expand industrial soon as well, which I can do easily. But that's going to be it for this episode, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. And yeah, 5 likes and there'll be another episode tomorrow. I hope you've enjoyed all this one as much as I've enjoyed making it. And we are expanding this city. I've gone out to 100,000 now after upgrading those roads. They can be expensive. But that's going to be it, guys. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.